will go look at a Burma army camp up here that threatens this village. From this camp, the village has been burned 3 times. Right now there's a ceasefire, and so we don't expect anything much to happen, we hope. But we'll go take a look at it, and the Rangers will take photos, video, make a sketch, and determine what they think is happening in the camp. If it's being resupplied, if it's gotten bigger, what activities going on. And the purpose, again, is one, so we know what's happening. Second, if something bad is happening, we can warn the villagers. Third, we have an appreciation of the Burma Army situation. Fourth, it builds the morale of our guys. They don't have to be afraid of the Burma Army. They're humans also. Fifth, we can pray for them. Sixth, when we put the pictures out, the world can know, and the Burma Army can know what they're doing and why are they here. So these are some of the purposes.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So once again, vision comes back in, taking a look at the Burma Army camp. It's important for all the Burma people to be able to see, both to look out for their own safety, but also to help those who are poor. Rangers.
Dear God, ask for a safe trip that we can do all those things. Put a light on what's happening, know ourselves, not be afraid, pray for our enemies, and have a better understanding and be able to apply this in the areas that these Rangers live. And help us be a blessing to the Kanale too, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The same thing.
Yeah, that's fine.
Are Galawa girls going?
I don't think so. I think they've got GLC prep. It's, you know, really unlikely anything will happen. But they can mortar you and shoot you. It can happen. You're not supposed to, the ceasefire. Make this plan A. Plan A is tomorrow morning, we meet here at 7, and we go, and we recon, like, the same place as last year. The same position, there's 3 positions, closer, closer, and closer. And we will get two people from every team, so it's going to be about, like, 30 people, 40 people. Doesn't matter, the La Priva. And then we take turns, they rotate. You're the position, they change position, like that.
So what about headquarters? How many?
Only those that want to come and medic. Okay. And Joseph said he will come.
Okay.
And he will bring 2 other medics.
Yeah. The more people that can go on the recon, the better. Because this recon is very easy, and they can learn something.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can send 3 per team, good.
How long it will take?
It will take about an hour and a half to get there. Hour and a half to get back. That's 3. It'll take maybe 2 hours there. 5 hours, 6 hours. 5 or 6 hours. You leave here, let's say, meet at 7, you leave at 7:30. 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1, 2 o'clock, maybe 2 o'clock finish.
Hey, you came to see me?
January 2nd, and this is a day where we will be like the bear. The bear went over the mountain to see what he could see.
Morning, I got a hat for you.
not the color you love, but it makes you like all the rest of the ducks.
I understand.
Good morning.
Good morning.
God bless you. So today we'll go look at a Burma Army camp up here that threatens this village. From this camp, the village has been burned 3 times.
All right, K1.
What?
What? How many? Luya. K1, AB, huh? Luya. Where are you? K1. Thank you. K2. Kiga. All right. K3, Soba, no? K5. K5, Kilo. 1, 2, 3, 4. K6. 1, 2, 3, 4. K7, 1, 2, SSA, North, 1, 2, 3, 4, SSA, South, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, sorry, Kachin, 1, 2, Arakan, 1, 2, Lahu, 1, 2, 3, 4, Who am I missing? Karenni.
Yeah.
1, 2. So, this is north. Okay, Tadada down here.
Tadada, you are the only here.
You gotta go, and this is the Yunzilin River. This is Mapu Burma Army Camp. This is the dirt road. This is the camp. This is the ridge, this side of the river, on the south and east side of the river. We will leave Tadada. We will walk to KNLA position. And meet with Karen security. And they will lead us, because sometime there's landmines on the way. So stay on the trail. And if they say no landmine, you don't have to worry. But listen to what the KNLA tell you. Alright. Once we get up, there's 3 recon positions. We're looking at Burma Army. One is on top of the ridge. About 1,000 meters from the camp. It's very far. Paji, but you can see a lot. Second position, a little closer, but you cannot see as much. About 700
meters.
The third position, you go down, cross the stream, and come back up and down again. This is only about 250-300 meters from the camp. Very close. And you can clearly see Burma Army, but it's you can only see this much of the camp. So divide this group into 3 teams. Team 1, Team 2, Team 3. All right, you will spend 30 minutes at each place. So, team 1, 2, and 3, you will all come here. Team 1 will stay, team 2 will go here, team 3. After 30 minutes, 3 will go to 1, 1 will go to 2, 2 will go to 3. And after 30 minutes, 2 will go to 1, 1 will go to 3, 3 will go to 2, like that. In the position, you need to take video and photo and draw. Someone on your team draw a sketch. On your sketch, what do you need? You need the name of the place, in this case, Mapu Camp. You need the date and time. So today is, for example, Mapu Camp, 2 January 2017, 7:20. You need the north arrow. You need the description. You need to draw whatever is important.
You need a key.
For example, here, the key. 1, 2, 3 equal recon position. So someone can understand your map. This road. Dirt road. What kind of road? This stream. You need a key. What else you need? For your map. You need scale. How big? So for my map, about 300 meters. So that's about 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, 4 inch, about 800 meters. So on my map, I put up here scale.
Yeah, 300 meters.
1 inch equal 100 meters. 100 meter, 200 meter, 300 meter, 400 meter, 500 meter, 600 meter, 700 meter. So they know how far.
Bunker? Then
bunker like that.
House look like that.
If you see the big hole for the mortar, you go like this. You see the car? You draw what it looks like. You see a tank? You draw a tank. No tank here. But one time we counted 70 truck. 70. When they were attacking the Karen, they brought 70 truck with supplies. And one time they captured a lot of villager and forced them to carry the load. And we got the photo and made a report.
And the day before that, Tan Shui, he told the United Nations, we never capture the prisoner and make them carry the load. We never use the villagers to carry the load. But the very next day, we publish our photo. Alright, the purpose, we have many purpose why Free Burma Ranger does recons. Number one, we want to know what the enemy is doing. We don't want to be blind. We want to understand them. Number two, so that the if Burma Army is coming to attack, we can see and warn the people. Number three, so we can take photo and report to the world. This is the Burma Army camp in Karen State, in Shan State, in Arakan State. Why? Why are they in our country? Another reason, number four, is so that if there is some human rights violation, if they have some prisoner or some villagers, you can take photo of it. Number five, so that when you see the Burma army, you realize there are people just like you. You don't need to be afraid of them. Number six, when we make the news about them, eventually the Burma army will see that we take photo of them. Someone is watching them. They cannot do in secret the thing they want to do. And the last reason, so we can see them, we pray for them to change. So this is some of the reason we do the recon. Every place is different. Some camps, you can get very close, some camps very far. Don't get captured or killed. There is ceasefire right now. So we cannot get too close. If we get too close, there'll be a fighting and become a political problem. But so we'll get about 800 to 1,000 meter, about 700 meter, about 300 meters. And but sometimes, some places, you'll be able to get very close. If you see there's some human rights violation or something important happening, try to get very close. In some places, you have to be very far away. If you get close, you'll be fighting. In some places, the Burma army is on the road and you pass them every day and nothing happened. So you pray and make plan together how you do recon of Burma army in your area. For example, in Shan State, a few years ago, we went on the mission. And we are looking at Burma army about 1,000 meter away, taking photo of their camps. Then one of the Shan team, who is from that area, he changed clothes, become like a villager. Who has a camera?
Camera
behind you.
Regular camera.
Here's one.
Yeah, okay. So he went to the Burma army. To the camp.
What we want to do is take close picture of Burma Army Camp, but we cannot. So he went to the camp in the civilian clothes and with the camera up to the front gate. And act like he's very stupid. He said, my uncle gave me this camera. I don't know how to use it. I know the Burma Army, very smart. Can you show me? Yes. And the Burma Army take many photos for him. And even like this together. And good recon. And he came back. So very dangerous. But you pray and you think how you can do. One time, the Burma Army is making the road. And they use the bulldozer to make the road. But they said to the world, they're not doing that. They don't want anyone to see their bulldozer. They also don't want the KNLA to blow it up. So one of our rangers dressed like IDP. And he made a fire by the road. And cooked a tea. And he already looked very crazy. And when the Burma Army came, he said, oh, Burma Army, you want some tea? They're very surprised. Okay, they drink a tea. He said, I heard you have the very big car. In my whole life, I never see one. I really want to see it. Come with us, we will show you our big car. He has basket with banana and something inside. But in the bottom, he has video camera. And he turned it on. And video of bulldozer. Very good. We made the news about the bulldozer. Later, KNLA blow it up. So you pray and talk together how you can get the news. Don't die for it. But FBR, you have two main missions. Help the people. Get the news out. In your own area, you will know how to do it. So this camp we're going to is called Mapu. From this camp, they burned this village 3 times already. Right now, ceasefire. So don't start the fight. But if they shoot at you, you ask God what to do. You can shoot back. I will take the blame. But try not to let them see you. So no fire. Don't talk too loud. Like that. Galawa, we have to look like this. So, any question? Dear God, ask for a safe trip that we can do all those things. Put a light on what's happening, know ourselves, not be afraid, pray for our enemies, and have a better understanding, and be able to apply this in the areas that these rangers live. And help us be a blessing to the KNLA too, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Now, have we divided into 3 groups yet?
No.
Really? Okay. So who's in charge of each group? What is this?
Ta.
What is this?
Chairman.
Spread out.
Chairman.
Spread out. What is this?
Mine.
Landmine. What is this?
Tabla.
Danger.
Yandu.
Tabla.
Okay, what is this?
Yandu.
Do that, enemy. What is this?
Yeah.
I see. Okay. You guys know all this? Okay, you repeat after me.
Yeah,
but the way you hand an arm signals is get in a line, we're going this way. You make eye contact with the guy behind you. Don't just throw up a signal. I mean, the guy may be tripping over something or tying his shoe. And you do exactly what the person does, and don't make it sloppy. Otherwise, it's like telephone. It becomes indiscernible. So you guys just get in line like this and follow me. So we're walking.
Okay, this means halt, which means you can move around. No talking, but you can move around. You can sit down, you can stand up, you can lean against a tree, do whatever you want, but you're not moving. You're not going forward or backward in, you know, more than 3 or 4 steps. Now, I'm looking at the person behind me. That's you, honey. You got to look at me first to get my signal. And then you look at the next person.
Now, if I do like this, that's freeze. You don't take any more. Nope, that's freeze. You didn't freeze. It's instant freeze. Whatever position you're in, you instantly freeze. There's a difference between halt and freeze. Halt means we're just stopping for whatever reason. Doesn't matter. Freeze means I'm probably looking at a guy 3 feet from me, and if he picks up motion back here, you're going to get shot. So you just got to trust me. As soon as you see this, it's like you don't even make a flinch. If you're, you know, your canteen's in your mouth, you don't move it. Everything is frozen. I started that way, but I did this.
Oh.
Hey, wait. Come on. Mistake. You got to take it seriously, honey, or don't get in this line.
Yes, sir.
This is your also teaching. On the way, you get to some place that everyone can recognize. A big tree, a big rock, a stream. When we cross it, we'll go like this. That means if something happened ahead, we'll come back and meet there together. And this is the signal.
All right.
Any question? All right. So the Galawa will go with group number
3.
And you got it.
You go take 5 minutes.
Yeah. How many?
2, 3.
Go!
Well, you're always the last one of the of the file.
Well, now we're teachers, so yep. Let them go, and we help from the back. Unless there's fighting, then we go to the front.